Ever since I started my YouTube channel, this one common question about certifications has always been coming to me from various sources, your lovely emails, your DMs, your messages, and you all are so curious to understand what kind of certification you should go for, how you should advance your career in IT. So based on my research from various sources, I have come up with these five top IT certifications as far as the pay scale is concerned. Now this could vary from time to time and from source to source, but overall these five certifications are indeed very popular as of today in IT industry. And if you want to pursue any one of these, I think this video is for you. Hello friends, welcome to ITK Funde, your own channel where we make IT interesting for everyone. And without further ado, let's get into the details of these five certifications with highest pay scale in IT industry. Thank you friends, if you're new to ITK Funde channel, we make IT interesting for everyone, be it IT or non-IT. We discuss all the latest tools and technologies, products, productivity hacks and career tips on this channel. So if you're new and if you like the content, do consider subscribing. Thank you. So friends, these are the top five certifications which we'll discuss today. So, and it is as per the descending order of the pay scale. The very first certification is Google Certified Professional Cloud Architect, and this goes into cloud architecture or cloud architect, cloud solution architect category. What is required in this? You need to design, develop, scale, manage robust IT solutions on Google Cloud, and this you would do by understanding all the different kinds of products and services which Google Cloud provides on its platform. It's a wide area and you need to have a very wide knowledge of the whole Google Cloud platform. And for all these certifications, there are too many details. I cannot share it in one video. So what I will do, I will give you the links or the exam guides so that you can go through the detail of exact contents of each certification. The cost of Google Cloud certification for Cloud Architect is $200. And the average salary as per the data in United States is on an average $175,000 or which is $175,000 per year. Now when we say that, okay, this cost, exam cost or the certification cost, I have taken it from certain sources and it could continue to change or vary as the time goes by, but you can take it as an example, but don't correlate it with India or any other country because it might change as per geography or as per the environment in which you are applying. But you can take this as a study which was done in United States. So the second in the rank is AWS Certified Solution Architect Associate. It is very similar to the certification we discussed for GCP. Again, the category is Cloud Architect, and the roles and responsibilities under this this certification is very similar to what we have discussed for GCP, Google Cloud. Similarly, we need a solution architect who can understand various products and services of provided by AWS Cloud and design, develop, plan, manage robust IT solutions on Amazon Cloud. The price for this certification is $150 and the average salary is $150,000 per year. So third in line is CISM, Certified Information Security Manager. This goes in the famous category of cybersecurity. Cybersecurity is a booming area with cloud computing and various cloud vendors putting more and more data into the cloud, more systems in the cloud. The need for cybersecurity is too high right now, and it would continue to go higher. So what is required under CISM certification? You need to assess, design, plan all the different IT security solutions for a business, especially on the cloud. For cybersecurity CISM certification, the cost is dependent on your membership for the community which provides it, which is ISECA. It is an open community, but if you are a member, you need to pay $465. But if you are a non-member, then you would need to pay $565 for the exam. Again, I will give all the details of these certifications in the description so you can read more about these certifications from the links. The salary, the average salary as per US data is $149,000 per year. So again, if you are a guy who's working in networking, who's good in network security, IT security, then you can go about, targeting this particular certification. At fourth place, we have CRisk, which is certified in risk and information system control. Again, this is a certification which is provided by ISACA. And what is required here is that how you manage risk in any organization, how you plan, how you assess, how you identify, and how you avoid any risks or threat to an organization. Again, you know, a very good certification if you are, you know, very good in risk management and you want to go into this field, then you can go for this certification. The member charges for it is $575 and non-member is $760. And the average salary for this is $146K per year. And at the fifth place, we have our Evergreen certification, PMP, which is Project Management Professional. This is provided by PMI Institute and Project Management Institute, which is PMI. What is required here? So you need to have certain amount of hours as a project manager, and you need to showcase your capability of how you can deliver projects, how you can plan various aspects or facets of project management, like budget, processes, people management, risks, all those things. And you need certain hours in your in your experience to go for this PMP certification. A very good certification if you are a project manager, if you want to pursue project management. Obviously, all these five certifications are little advanced. So if you are a beginner into IT, if you are getting into IT industry, these certifications might need some hands-on experience, a real on-the-ground experience before you target. But having said that, now there are so many courses which could give you that leverage. So you can think about it. But obviously, these certifications do require some hands-on ground experience. So talking about PMP, we have member certification. Again, you need to, if you are a member for PMI organization, then you have a fee of $405. But if you are a non-member and you want to give this certification, the fees is $555. So yes, these are the top five certifications, and you can now plan any of these certifications. But before we end this video, I would want to share my experience and my opinion about certifications. To be very honest, I am not a certifications guy. It is a difficult journey. It takes a lot of time and effort. And you would see people who would do certifications pretty much in every area very quickly. They put those hours. Obviously, it varies from person to person. But if you talk about your job probabilities being a certified person, definitely with so much competition, if you are getting applying for a new job or a new role, if you are already certified, that gives you an edge in profiling and the screening level. So definitely your profile would have enough weightage and you would be given an opportunity to appear for an interview. But whether you will get a job or not is not entirely dependent on certification. And I would highly recommend that only do certifications if you really like working in a certain area, if you really want to develop in that particular area. If you have really hands-on experience in that area, only then I would recommend to go for that certification. Because doing certification just for the namesake, in my opinion, does not add any value, and I do not personally believe in that. So you do certification, but only when you can prove it on the ground. That has been my fundamental principle, but obviously it might vary from person to person. But I would highly recommend that please do that hands-on. It could be through Coursera, it could be through Udemy, but the best part could be if you are working in that job or in that profile in a company. That would be the best experience. But one very good thing about certification is it definitely takes you out of your comfort zone. I have personally felt it. Last time I was giving my Prince 2 certification, and that was a very, very tough time for me, because studying and preparing for certifications are not easy. It takes a lot of time, dedicated time. So in that sense, I would highly recommend that you do certifications if you're not doing anything challenging currently in your job profile or in your life as a whole. And then obviously your real hands-on experience would matter at the end. So I think, yes, I hope this information would be useful for you, and you might want to pursue any of these certifications. Do let me know in the comment section if you want to know any other information about these certifications, or if you can suggest other certifications which are good. There are plenty. I'm I'm sure I'm aware of it. But if you can put that into the comment section, it would help the community at large, and they would, you know, they would be able to go for those certifications as well. Do let me know if you want me to make certain this kind of videos in future, and maybe in certain areas I would do my research and I will try to bring this content to you. But yes, if you have liked this video and if you got any value out of it, don't forget to hit the like button, because when you hit the like button, YouTube actually understands that you know, there is something useful which is being shared on this channel, and it will then share it with, you know, the masses. So until next time, please keep sharing all your knowledge, keep working hard, and yes, as always, keep hustling. Bye for now.